إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وبعد فإن خير الكلام كلام الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد الله سبحانه وتعالى says in his book يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا وقودها الناس والحجارة عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. O you who believe, ward off from yourselves and your families a fire. Protect yourselves and your family from a fire whose fuel is men and stones, over which, meaning that hellfire, are appointed angels who are stern and strong and severe and who do not disobey, meaning disobey Allah, from executing the commandments that they receive from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they do what they are commanded. Al-Shaykh Muhammad ibn Salih Al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala, after advising the Muslims to fear Allah, after reciting this ayah, and to save themselves from the hellfire, he then gave them the meaning, us, we the Muslims, after reciting this ayah, he gave us the meaning of save themselves, means protect oneself from it, meaning the hellfire, and that can only be done by complying with the commandments of Allah and the commandments of His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and staying far away from what Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam have prohibited, and by establishing that which Allah azza wa jal has enjoined upon us. And then the Shaykh said, rahimahullah, Allah has placed the responsibility of the care, or the charge, or the protection, specifically regarding the women. That this ayah, Shaykh al-Uthaymeen says, is in general with the families, but more specifically with the women. He said, because the women are in need of an additional care and attention, an added protection and charge, an added maintenance and supervision, because they have deficiencies in their intellect and deficiencies in their religion. And then he said, as the leader of all the messengers and prophets, alayhi as-salatu wassalam, has mentioned to us, the one who does not speak from himself or his own desire of what he's informed with from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Shaykh al-Uthaymeen said, we know that the deficiencies in the women, in their intellect, in their aql or common sense as some call it, and their religion is also proved. The evidence for it is from al-waqi' al-mahfuz, from tangible facts testify to the fact of the deficiency in the women, in their aql and in their deen. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال يا معشر النساء فصدقنا وأكثرنا الاستغفار فإني رأيتكن أكثر أهل النار فقالت امرأة منهن جزلة وما لنا يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أكثر أهل النار قال تكثرنا اللعن وتكفرنا العشير ما رأيت من ناقصات عقل ودين أغلب لذي لب منكنا. قالت يا رسول الله ما نقصان العقل والدين؟ قال أما نقصان عقلها فشهادة امرأتين تعدل شهادة رجل، فهذا نقصان العقل، وتمكث الليالي لا تصلي وتفطر في رمضان، فهذا نقصان الدين. From Abu Huraira رضي الله تعالى عنه، he said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, O party of women, give in charity and seek forgiveness a lot. Seek forgiveness, meaning of Allah, a great deal. For I indeed have seen that from you, you form, meaning you people, you the women, you form the majority of the people of hell. So a woman who was amongst them when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made this statement, and the narrator Abu Huraira, he said a woman who was jazla, who was jazla, a woman who was jazla, meaning ذَاتُ عَقْلٍ وَرَأِي ذَاتُ عَقْلٍ وَرَأِي, that she is a woman who is wise and had intelligence, she had wisdom, she had strong ideas, showing that the women are not deficient totally. He said sallallahu alayhi wasallam to answer her when she said, O Messenger of Allah, why are we the majority in the hellfire? This wise woman, this intelligent woman, she asked the question. He said, because you curse too much. May the curse of Allah be on you. May the curse of Allah be on you. And you are ungrateful to your husbands. You are ungrateful to your spouses. I see none lacking in common sense, meaning in aql, or failing, weakness, frailty, deficiency in religion, but at the same time, meaning with those two deficiencies, you rob a man who is hazim in one narration. Rajulun hazim, a man who is dabit amrihi, a man who has the ability to master the affairs and control himself, and he has accuracy. With all that deficiency that you have, you can rob a man of his intelligence and his wisdom. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, I have not seen anyone who has these types of deficiencies able to rob a man of his intelligence and his wisdom. The woman says, O Messenger of Allah, what is wrong with our aql and our deen, the deficiency? What is wrong? Meaning, explain the nuqsan. Explain the nuqs. Explain it to us, O Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In other words, just don't leave us hanging, because we may misinterpret the statement that you're bringing. So what is the deficiency? Explain and clarify for us, O Messenger of Allah, what is specifically the deficiency in the aql and the deen? He said, you lack aql, you have nuqsan of the aql, you lack common sense, meaning in your deen, in your aql, because it takes two women to be a witness, and those two women are equal to the testimony of one man as a witness. This is the proof of your deficiency in aql. And you spend some nights and some days where you don't pray and you don't fast, in another narration, in the month of Ramadan, and you have a deficiency in your religion. This is a deficiency in your religion. Sheikh Abdul Aziz Ibn Abdullah Ibn Baz Rahimahullahu Ta'ala, the Mufti of our Ummah of our time, when he was asked about the meaning of this hadith, and after giving an elaborate explanation and clarification for those people who try to twist the meaning of this hadith, either because they're ignorant or because they're deviated. They have deviated. And we're talking about the men. We're not talking about the women. We're talking about the men who try to twist this hadith and say, you see, the women are deficient. Sheikh bin Baz, after giving an elaborate explanation and clarification. He said, so it is not befitting for the believer to charge her with deficiency. What he means by believer is the Muslim man. So it is not befitting, لا ينبغي للمؤمن, to charge the woman with deficiency in every aspect or weakness of her religion from every side or angle. For indeed, the Sheikh said, the deficiency is only specific feebleness, only specific feebleness in her religion. And the frailty in her intelligence is related to accuracy of testimony or witnessing and the like. He says, therefore, it is incumbent to have justice and fair treatment of her and understand the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the best and most correct interpretation, and Allah the Sublime knows best. The end of the statement of the Shaykh. Shaykh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, he said, فالمرأة قاسية النظر والتبكير ونظرها لا يتجاوز قدميها وتكفيرها مضطرب لا يقر على شيء كل شيء يغيره عاطفتها متداعية كل شيء يجذبها ويميل بها. Sheikh Uthaymeen, he said, and listen closely, you women, listen very, very closely, because this is for your benefit. And you men, you better listen real close. Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, the Imam al-Shafi'i of our time, he said, so since the woman is short-sighted and limited in her thinking and speculation, her sight does not go beyond her feet. This is the way she is. Her sight and her vision doesn't go beyond her feet. And her weighing up of matters is uneasy or agitated. And her thinking is not settled or firm on things. Everything changes it. And her feelings or her emotions beckon her to any and everything, pulling her from one side to the other, causing her to lean towards it. Then the Sheikh says, therefore, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has appointed the men as those endowed with a higher superiority than her and a higher standard than her by the statement of Allah as a proof. الرجال قوامون على النساء بما فضل الله بعضهم على بعض وبما أنفقوا من أموالهم. Sheikh Uthaymeen recited this ayah. Men are the protectors and the maintainers of the women because Allah has made one, meaning the man, superior over the other. Allah has made the men excel over the other, and the other reason why we're above them is because of what the men spend supporting them from their means. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he said, يقول تعالى الرجال قوامون على النساء أي الرجل قيم على المرأة أي هو رئيسها وكبيرها والحاكم عليها ومؤدبها إذا وجد. He said, Allah says, men are the protectors and maintainers of the women. Move up closer, brothers. Move up closer, brothers. Move up closer. Make room, and Allah will make room for you in Jannah. Men are the protectors and maintainers of the women. Meaning, the man is in charge of the woman. The man is the president for the woman. The man is the head of the woman. He's the leader. He's the head of the household. He's the one who disciplines her and educates her and shows her manners and her etiquette. If she goes astray, if she becomes bent, if she becomes crooked, he says, and the statement of Allah, بِمَا فَضَّلَ اللَّهُ بَعْدَهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ, that because they spend to support them from their means, لِأَنَّ الرِّجَالِ أَفْضَلُ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ وَالرَّجُلُ خَيْرٌ مِنَ الْمَرْأَةِ وَلِهَذَا كَانَتَ النُّبُوَّةِ مُخْتَصَّةً بِالرِّجَالِ وَكَذَلِكَ الْمُلْكُ الْأَعْظَمُ لِقَوْلِهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ لَنْ يُفْلِحَ قَوْمٌ وَلَّوْا أَمْرَهُمْ امْرَأَةٌ. He says, and because they spend to support them from their means, this refers to the dowries. This refers to the dowries. من المهور والنفقات والكلف التي أوجبها الله عليهم لهن. He says, this is from them spending on their dowries and spending on the women's maintenance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enjoined upon them. Why? Because they have been excelled over them. Because the prophets, nubuwwah, prophethood is only for the men. And the khalifa is only for the men. And no judge can be anything except a man. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no people shall prosper, no nation shall prosper, no community, no country shall prosper who has appointed a woman as their ruler. So Allah has made the man inherently, innately, intrinsically, naturally superior, more better than the woman. He's superior to her because he spends on her. He spends from his own money. So it's appropriate that he should be in charge. Why? وَلِلْرِجَالِ عَلَيْهِنَّ دَرَجَةً. Because Allah says in another place, the men have a degree over the woman. Then Shaykh al-Uthaymeen, رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, he says, فَقُومُوا أَيُّهَا الرِّجَالِ بِمَا جَعَلَكُمُ اللَّهُ قَوَّامِينَ بِهِ وَلَا تَبْخَصُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ حَقَّهَا لَا تُغَلِّبَنَّكُمُ النِّسَاءَ عَلَى رُجُولَتِكُمْ وَلَا يُلْهِينَكُمْ الشَّيْطَانُ عَنْ رِعَايَةِ أَهْلِيكُمْ وَلَا تَنْشَغِلُوا بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ عَنْ أَوْلَادِكُمْ وَلَا بِمَكَاسِبِكُمْ عَنْ أَخْلَاقِكُمْ وَالشَّرَفِكُمْ. You men, listen to the statement of Shaykh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen. After all those statements from the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Imam ibn Kathir, listen to what the Shaykh is telling you men, the men over the women. He says, O men, establish what Allah appointed for you by being superior. Do not neglect yourselves. Do not neglect your souls regarding its rights. Do not allow the women to overcome or conquer your rujula, your manhood. Do not allow the women to overcome or conquer your masculinity, your virility. Don't let them strip you of your masculinity. He said, and do not allow the devil to divert your attention away from caring for your families. Do not allow your wealth to make you neglectful, or your children, nor your earnings from displaying good character and nobility. عن ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنه وعن أبيه قال لعن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المتشبهين من الرجال بالنساء والمتشبهات من النساء بالرجال. Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنهما, he said, the messenger of Allah curse the men who imitate the women and the women who imitate the men. This is collected by Imam al-Bukhari. Why do we mention this hadith, brothers? Why do we mention the hadith of the men imitating the women and the women imitating the men? It's because the roles have reversed. Shaykh al-Uthaymeen said that the woman is short-sighted. She's deficient in this, she's deficient in that. She can't look beyond her feet. I guarantee you, and Allah knows best, that half of the women sitting next door right now, when they heard that description, they said to themselves, that's the men. The men are the ones who are short-sighted. The men are the ones who their emotions make them go this way, that way. The men are the ones who follow their desires the most. The men are the ones who can't look beyond their feet. Why? It's because the roles have reversed. We have become like women. We don't spend on them, and they spend on us, and we like it. We invite it. We encourage it. The Sheikh says, don't let those women that have a deficiency strip you of your masculinity. So what do? You look for the one with Section 8. You look for the one that got some money. You look for the one who's able to help you with the bills, because you ain't a real man. You strip yourself by someone who has left no greater fitna on the men of this ummah except themselves. Wallahu musta'an. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الأمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحابه أجمعين وبعد. These are questions from the Khatib today to you men. Is it correct for a man to notice the weakness in another woman and have a need for helping another woman outside of his wife while neglecting the same needs that is also found in his present wife, meaning wanting to run off and marry another woman while your wife has the same needs? What makes the men look to increase the women in his family before fulfilling the trust and the basic needs with the first wife? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his magnificent book, Al-Hakum al-Takafur. The mutual rivalry for piling up of the worldly things diverts you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says again, اعلموا أنما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو وزينة وتفاخر بينكم وتكاثر في الأموال والأولاد. Know that the life of this world is only play and amusement and pomp and the mutual boasting amongst you men, and rivalry and competition and respect of wealth and children. And how are you going to pile up children, brothers, unless you get more than one wife? The more wives you get, the more children you get. So the result of boasting and competing to have children comes as a direct result of piling up the women by boasting and showing off. The ulama of Islam, they say that this is israf. When a man does this for this reason, he is extravagant. How many times, or should we say many times, more than that, the men rush off to aid a damsel in distress, coming on his white horse to pick up another wife, to put her on the back of his nice white horse, the knight in shining armor, while leaving his wife backwards sitting on a donkey. You run off and haven't fulfilled the trust and the basic needs of your wife at home, and you running off to marry another woman while that other woman at home is helping to take care of you. You tell me if this is permissible. You tell me from the book of Allah and the authentic sunnah, is this permissible? So it seems now, brothers, that the higher benefit of seeking another wife has been lost, which is the pleasure of Allah tabaraka ta'ala, and it's been lost to satisfying the lower desires. It's been lost by trying to satisfy boasting that I got two, I got three, I got four. Marrying more than one woman is a matter that no one will disagree with. Is highly recommended in Islam with shuruf conditions. The first condition, that the man be financially able. The second condition, that he be physically able for it. The third condition, that he be able to trust, to treat his wife justly and fairly. Plural marriage, brothers, has a lot of benefits. It includes protecting the chastity of the women. The women who we married, that is. Bringing people closer together and producing a lot of children and a lot of other benefits. But when a man goes off to marry more than one wife by way of boasting and taking it as a challenge to prove himself and to prove his wujuda, his masculinity, the ulama say this is a form of israf. It is a form of extravagance. وَلَا تُصْرِفُوا إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. Verily, Allah does not love those who are extravagant. Don't be extravagant. So where's the benefit, brothers? Where's the benefit in polygyny? You have allowed that woman who has a deficiency in her aql specifically, and has a deficiency in her deen, who is a fitna, naturally, on the men, you have helped that woman be more of a fitna on another woman, your wife. And then, when you realize that she wasn't the woman for you, because you didn't ask basic questions, is this the type of woman that's going to help me get to Jannah? Is this the type of woman who I want to bear my children? Is this the kind of woman that when a trial hits, she will continue to benefit me? So what happens is, you divorce her. And then another brother picks her up. And then he divorces her. And another brother picks her up. And then he divorces her. And then another brother picks her up. So three brothers, four brothers, five brothers, six, seven, eight, nine, ten brothers standing toe to toe, shoulder to shoulder in the same masjid, one in front rank, one in the back rank, one in the middle rank, all of them have seen your wife uncovered. Every single one of them. Why? It's because we let that woman who has a deficiency in those specific areas, the one who is short-sighted, make us like her. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is as though, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it is as though, this hadith is a very appropriate, Allah curses, and the Messenger cursed the men who imitate the women. Be men, brothers. If you can't afford it, stop the fitna by being patient until you can come with the conditions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me and you. Hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahabatihi ajma'in.